I'll take it.
Hi there, I'm Nick, and in this video, I'll be giving you my review on the Level Up Career Fair that recently hit London, Ontario, hosted by the Ministry of Labour and Skills Ontario. I don't think we've ever had an event like this in London before. We have the Ministry of Labour on site, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, Skilled Trades Ontario, Skills Ontario, ApprenticeSearch.com, all our union leaders, Fanshawe College, St. Clair College, the list goes on and on and on. With an event like this, you have to set the tone early. That's when you call in Dan Cardinal of Skills Ontario. He might be the best hype man when it comes to promoting skilled trades. Heck, he'd probably give Bruce Buffer a run for his money. I had the pleasure at this event to be volunteering with the Ministry of Labour and Skills Ontario at both of their setups. After listening to Dan's introduction, the students got to explore the exhibits. And let me tell you, there was quite a few of them, and some really stood out. The Skills Ontario truck and trailer is a sight to behold if you've never seen it before. It is a trailer just packed with tons of virtual reality equipment that you can perform exercises on, as well as electrical setups, fire alarm setups, wheel changing stations. The list goes on and on here. Another exhibit that really stood out to me on a few levels was the Sheet Metal Workers Union, Local 473. This exhibit was allowing youth to make either toolboxes or rose pedals or both. And the kids were so engaged. It might have been one of the busiest exhibits at the entire career fair. And as a sheet metal worker myself, it holds a special place in my heart. But on top of all that, we had four female sheet metal workers working in this exhibit, which is just awesome to see. If you've seen any of my videos in the past, or if you followed me on LinkedIn or my other socials, you know that I'm a huge advocate for getting more women into trades. And when it comes to sheet metal, you don't necessarily see a lot of women. So it's nice to see this kind of change happening. We need more of that. I've tried to pick apart this event to find some negatives in it, because it's impossible to say everything was perfect. And there is one takeaway that I did not necessarily care for, and that was the open house in the evening of the first night, where parents were able to bring their children in and explore the exhibits. The part that bothered me about that was it was only, I think, an hour and a half long. It could have been much longer. And I know it might not have been feasible, but maybe a weekend setup would have really made this event much better. Other than that, I don't know that it was advertised enough to the general public. I got a sense afterwards from some of my friends, they had no idea this event was even in town. And that's unfortunate, because they missed out on a heck of an event. Now, I could yap all day, which I'm excellent at doing, but we're not here for that. Why don't we check out some of the footage that I obtained from the event, and you can see for yourself what you were missing out on. In terms of things that I really enjoyed about this event, I do have a few takeaways. The children that did attend seemed genuinely excited about exploring the trades. To me, that's a huge win right there. I had an opportunity to speak with Melissa Young for the very first time, CEO of Skilled Trades Ontario. And one of the coolest moments to me was bumping into Scott Ravery of the Ministry of Labor. He is the person that handled my apprenticeship contract almost 20 years ago when I first signed up as an apprentice. You've got to hear firsthand from either organizers, volunteers, coordinators, or even trades people like myself about the realities of trades. And I really think they appreciated that. It would also be silly of me not to point out that Minister of Labor, Monty McNaughton, made an appearance on the first day. I think that's pretty awesome because I think everybody knows how busy his schedule is. So the fact that he was able to make it down and talk to many of us was fantastic. Anyhow, to wrap this up, I love the event. I love the opportunity to participate in it. I know everyone involved had a phenomenal time. And I would really like to thank all the tradespeople that came out, took time out of work to help explore the trades with these young people. Well, that ends my review of the Level Up Career Fair that was recently here in London, Ontario. And I think on that note, it's time to wrap it up.